All right, let's break things up for a little bit before we spend too much time on the Griffin gear thing. Contract, the Merry Widow. Geralt took a contract the gravedigger of Lindenvale had hung on the village's notice board. It seemed the village cemetery was full of monsters who seized children as their victims. Well, we can't have that, can we? So here we are in that place I said, Lindenvale, right? Right, just to the side of Crow's Perch where the Bloody Baron's located. There should be someone I can talk to around here about the goings-on in the local neighborhood. Where you at, sir? I want to test out my awesome new Griffin gear by casting all over people's faces. String.
Hear about the job. Seems you got a problem. Some graves get dug up.
If that were only it. Every now and then, a vile beast had come round the graveyard, devour what's fresh, then move on. Started again not long past. Thought to myself, just don't step out after dark and lock your door tight. But then a young'un went missing.
From the graveyard?
Nay, from the village. Little snotter wouldn't have come here of his own. And I'd heard something like a whimper in the night.
Didn't bother to come out, see what was happening?
Think me daft? If you've monsters, you need a witcher.
Let's talk about my reward.
Rate's fair, considering the job. I know a bit about these things.
See if I can learn what's out there.
I miss my halberdier armor, or whatever it was called. My flowing, like, red, like, split cape on the front and back, or whatever you call that. I actually don't know what that's called. When you have sort of, like, a flowing cape over your legs, but it's kind of front and back. It's just, like, just a long shirt, basically. So I have to go up here to get to the cemetery. I have taken the worst possible path. I should have found the road. Alright, we made it. Never mind. Everything's fine. Howdy, y'all. Alright, who's been digging up bodies? Are there bad things over there? Oh, yeah, there are. Rabid dogs. I'll show you, rabid dog. I attacked nothing. Are they gonna come after me or run away? Did that one just die? Or did it kill something? What the fuck? Oh, well.
Grave's been dug up recently. Smell of cadaverine's old, though. Overripe. Wonder where the stench will lead me.
Where's the stench gonna lead me? Is it on my map? Oh, hello, friends. Burn, burn, yes, you've got to burn. Somehow none of them were in that range, okay. Dogs? There's a bunch of dead things on the map. Am I actually hitting dogs and not noticing quite? Sorry, I feel bad now. I mean, they were kind of after me. Is there another one coming? Yeah, there is. I keep shooting too early. It's a problem. Doggy, 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 whimper. Do you feel bad? I feel bad. I mean, you probably feel worse because you're on fire, but you know, semantics. Ow, dick. All you have to do is go away. Stupid. Stupid dogs. Now I'm just gonna take all your remains. I rip all this raw meat and dog tallow out of corpses with blinding speed. That's another rabid dog over there. What were they eating? Something's dead around here. Hello, doggy. Oh, you're still alive. What is over here? Oh, they're just rabbits.
Ghouls dug up the graves. Then the stench of decay attracted wild dogs. But neither ghouls nor dogs steal kids.
You don't know that. Do you? I guess you might know that. Why can't I loot this rabbit? There we go. I'm going crazy here. I'm like, where's the prompt? Alright. Follow the scent of Katarine using your witcher senses. Am I following it into here? What's over here? Oh, loot. Cavalry trousers. Probably not worthwhile. Okay, light the candles. It's honor of the dead, yo. Oops. Accidentally put them out. Oh, goddammit. I should not have started doing this. The controls for this stuff is the worst. There we go. Almost expected the Legend of Zelda style da 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 when you finished them all. Like, you found the secret. Congratulations. Where's the scent? I'm following a scent. Oh, there it is. I was confused. I'm like, I didn't see it show up for some reason at first. And I was trying to look in that direction, I thought. Alright, where is this leading to? This wibbly-wobbly scent. It's always surprisingly not very far. You'd think it, in many cases, it seems like something you'd have to hunt for ages, but it never seems to go very far. Jump! Why didn't I jump? Oh, cool. He can jump amazingly high. Yeah, I don't know why he didn't jump. Oh, wait, I have to be running, don't I? That's what the problem was. I wasn't running, so he couldn't jump. Scent. There we go. What are we gonna find around here? Hello? Oop. Goes in this building. It's probably another beast of some kind. It's another werewolf. Surprise.
Whatever filth lives here sure chose an unusual place for its lair. Creature can use tools. Means it's sapient. Or just plain clever.
I mean, yeah, some types of spiders and squirrels can use tools. Birds can use tools.
Human skulls in a magic circle. Monsters clearly using them, drawing strength from the place of power.
I want a place of power.
Somebody's doing some cooking. This, it's a human femur. A child's. Gotta be a grave hag. Collected the skulls to draw the power through them. Confidence grew enough it started prowling the village. Need to take the skulls, force it to go back to the cemetery. I'll get it there. That ought to really piss it off. Now to lay low in the cemetery. It's likely to crawl out after dark.
Alright, let's look into this creature then. Glossary. Bestiary. It's a necrophage apparently. Grave hags. Cremation. Now that's one thing men could learn from gnomes. Burying bodies out in the fields, why, it's like laying out a welcome mat for monsters. Best case scenario, some ghouls will sniff them out, eat their fill, and be on their ghoulish ways. But if, God forbid, a grave hag takes to feeding your cemetery, you'll have no end of trouble. Jacques de Valvipin, Oxford University. A few monsters' names fit as well as the grave hags. As one might guess, these creatures resemble aged, deformed women and loiter near graveyards and battlefields. Grave hags feed on human corpses, and in particular on the rotten marrow, which they slurp from human bones using long, prehensile tongues. Gross. Once a hag has devoured all corpses within reach, she turns to killing men and burying them in the cemetery as she waits for them to decompose. Pleasant. All right. Morn Tart. This is what we're going after. Most grave hags rarely attack humans, preferring instead to feed on rotten remains they dig out of graves. Yet some individuals grow bold over the years and begin sneaking into huts to steal children and kill the elderly. Just such a monster was tormenting the inhabitants of Lindenvale. The Witcher knew this grave hag would put up a fierce fight. He would have to watch out for her powerful claws, capable of smashing through any block or parry, and her long, venomous tongue. He also realized her attacks would be so quick, not even his mutated reflexes would be able to keep pace, meaning only judicious use of the Yirden sign would all him to survive and conquer? Was that supposed to say allow? Judicious use of the Yirden sign would all him to survive and conquer. He's vulnerable to Blackblood Potion, Necrophage Oil, I think I have that, Yirden Signs, and Quen Signs. So we're going to use Potion, we're going to want to use Force Field and Slow. Let's look for Necrophage Oil. Spectre, Necrophage. There we go. All prepped for that. What time is it right now? It's 3 p.m. So I'm going to want to wait until 10 p.m. about. There we go. Now that it's late, probably not the smartest place to meditate, right in the middle of its lair, but now we're going to want to head out to the cemetery after dark, and it should show up. I'm going to go ahead and just choose. Let's start with Irden for the slowdown. Establish that first, then we can focus on defensive casting of Quen. What's this over here? I got a mug. Okay. I mean, I guess. There's an old man over here I can talk to if I really want to, because everyone really loves having me around. I'm taking the long path here, huh? I should just run straight towards the cursor. I got a little distracted looking at the path it was suggesting. Oh, right, that's why you want to follow the path. Because going up here on foot doesn't always work. It works fine. Is there a nasty? She's probably inside, huh? Look at all these rabbits around here. You could just shoot a crazy fire spell straight at them. Put the skulls in the cemetery and wait for the grave hag to come. That's not what I meant to do at all. Let's try this again. God damn it. God damn it. No! This part of the game is the worst part of the game. I want to delete all the candles from this game. How do you like my butt candle?
Thief! Skulls he stole. My skulls. Ought to dig up his own.
There she is. Right on cue.
Come get me, lady. Sup? Ow. Ow. Okay, remember that Reardon spell we're talking about? Alright. Morntart. Where you going, Morntart? Reardon spell. Alright. That'll be handy. Switch to Quen. Stay within the bubble. Keep ourselves safe. Where are you going, lady? Yep. Keep a distance. Stay in the circle. Oop. Okay, back to Irden really quick. Dodge backwards. Cast. Oh, wait. What did I cast? Did I not cast Irden? Shit. My mistake. Here we go. Hey, lady. Oh. Cast my... I just cast Irden again, didn't I? Quen is what I was going for. There we go. Got that off just in time for her to get her spell off. Oh yeah, that knockback's useful. I just keep casting it right before she hits me. There we go. Ow. Shield. Oh, okay. We need to get Irden back up. Back to Quen. Hey, lady. Nope. So polite of you to stay near my circle. Let's get some hit points real quick. That didn't really work. Oh well. Let's just try to finish her. Yitta. She's just gonna kind of hang out there. Casting Quen. There we go. Well, that was about as clean as a fight goes. Monster Essence, Grave Hag's Ear, Grave Hag Mutagen, Odin Deeth, and Grave Hag Trophy. That went really well. I'm actually really happy with that boss fight. That's probably one of the most skillful looking boss fight I've performed so far. That went pretty smoothly all around. Didn't even have to heal. Whoa. So my current silver sword has 30 armor piercing. This one does 40 more damage. It increases Axie and Ard intensity by 4%, 3% critical damage bonus, 2% critical hit chance, 1% chance to freeze, and 3 slots for upgrades. That's some scary shit right there. For example, can I put Quen? Oh, Quen only goes into armor. Igni, does that go into a sword? Nope. What does go into? I guess armor piercing. So I could give it armor piercing if I want to. Adrenaline point gain. Those are all tempting. Let's see. It's pretty strong, so I probably won't be replacing it very soon, right? Attack power goes into armor? Interesting. I'll give this weapon some armor piercing for now. That'll probably help against all these big monsters. What's the trophy gives me 10% chance to dismember. Not that worth it. Good chance I'll probably sell that. Wow, though. Already got an upgraded, better sword. Here's the trousers I found earlier. They're garbage. Alright. That went about as well as it could have.
Come on, Roach.
Let's go ahead and visit the grave digger for our reward, and then we'll look into getting more Griffin gear. I'll totally be shameless about the fact that I name each episode after a quest I do that episode, and I already named an episode after the Griffin quest, so I just wanted to do another quest this episode so I have something to call the episode.
You're about the job.
And?
It's taken care of. It was a grave hack that dug up the graves and snatched the child.
Aye? So, how is the little tyke?
Found him in the grave hag's lair. In her cauldron, to be precise. Want me to go on?
Might not even said that much.
What about my reward?
Oh, I've not forgotten, nay. Here you go. Thanks much for your help.
Take care.
There we go. These Witcher contracts pay pretty well. Alright, and 200 experience. These are all useful things. 249 crowns. Hey, I thought I'd bid for 250. You shorted me one crown. How dare you? Whatever. So now we'll go back to... Wow, I'm almost high enough level to go to Skellige of all places. I'm supposed to visit Triss for Pyres of Novigrad at some point. I want to finish getting my Griffin school gear, though. So I'm supposed to search the ruins of the fortress by the lighthouse. And I'm supposed to search the Lord's castle. So go to this menu so I can choose the objective. We're going to go for the fortress first. And the goal is currently 1,400 feet away. So I'm going to be probably teleporting to a closer location. Let's see, where am I going for? Somewhere up here. Oh, there it is. All right. We'll go to the Harpy Feeding Ground, a place I've been to before. And from that... Oh, that's the Abandoned Tower. I think that Abandoned Tower is where I got that... That super crazy Ursine equipment. Anyway, I'm gonna warp here. We're gonna probably check out this little thing over here and see what we can find as well. We're looking for the equipment. I just realized I probably shouldn't put that rune in my weapon.
That's it, Roach.
Oh, shit. Probably shouldn't have put that rune in my weapon because there's a good chance that the remaining equipment for me to gather could easily be two swords since we already have all the armor pieces. That's the main thing I can imagine it being. So I probably shouldn't have put anything into my new sword because the one I get, like, I could get one in a few minutes that's actually better. Maybe. Well, I arrived at the Harpy location and there's just a bot. Oh, the chest. Alchemist Powder, Nails, Alkahest, Dwarven Spirit, and Crowns. Just right here at the quick travel location. We're surrounded by corpses and stuff like that, which is not a great sign. Let's see. Go ahead and mark this spot to figure out what it is, since we want to investigate the environment as best we can. Because who knows what we'll find along the way. Don't hurt yourself with the fall. Okay, we're fine. Ish. Ish. What's this over here? Another body? Oh, dead harpy. Okay. Is this like some environmental storytelling? Was there like a harpy versus human conflict around here? I keep going after my objective, which is when I'm trying to go after my thing on the map. There's a lot of dead harpies around here. Are these the harpies I fought? Are their bodies persistent? Is that what I'm getting mixed up around here? I fought harpies, and I've been here before because this place is unlocked, but I don't remember if I left them behind. The other one's upstairs. Oh, nope, it's over here. That's a weird spot for the remains. Ah, I slid. There we go, harpy feathers and talons. Oh no. Oh no. I'm not being a very good geologist here with my terrible footing and I'm not really paying it. Oh, well, this is fun. Whee. There should be I guess it is a PC game actually. I wouldn't be surprised to find community mods that have something focusing around the sliding mechanic in this game. If this was Gary's mod, that kind of mechanic would definitely get some attention. This down take
Geralt Downhill Racers. Extreme.
Let's see. I may have taken a less than opportune path for going where I'm trying to go. Let's see if I can get closer. Nah, it's probably up on this rock, huh? Take a look at the map. Does it look like it's up on a rock? Oh, it's just behind the ridge. Okay. If I slide down, probably go through the water and then come back, I might be able to go past it. Assuming I don't suddenly die in a horrible surprise way the way I have in the situation in the past. Whee! What am I doing to myself? Okay. There we go. New mark. Oh, guarded treasure is what we're getting here. All right. What? Is that a griffin? Oh, okay. That's not on the list of things I'd expect to find here. Let's go ahead and put down a slow trap as if it attacks me. Okay, it's not that interested in attacking me, apparently. It's a cockatrice? Oh, it's a basilisk. Let's take a look at basilisks. I think the last one I found was a cockatrice. So this is might have slightly different stuff. Cockatrice. Yeah, I've never fought a basilisk before, but the cockatrice was... cockatrice? Cockatrices. Is weak against draconid oil and ard. This is clearly a similar type of creature, so... if I have draconid oil, I should put it on. I might not. Cursed oil. Let's see. Can I craft draconid oil? Draconid oil requires ergo seeds. Don't have those. Okay. And I don't think I had anything about a basilisk. It must just be a thing I've never encountered yet. Griffins and harpies. Really, a griffin's something different. Oh, that's confusing. Because a cockatrice seems a lot like a griffin. That's weak against ard. Oh, they're both weak against ard. That's fine. But that's hybrid oil. So is it a hybrid or a... I guess it doesn't matter. I probably can't do hybrid oil either, right? I don't think I have it. Do I even have a recipe for it? I don't have a recipe for it. Okay. Well, we know ard works here, apparently. I'll go ahead and double chug to be ready for combat. Get ready for my telekinetic blast. Hey, buddy. How you doing, Mr. Basilisk? How's it going? How you doing? Oop. Oop, he's flying away. Alright, we'll switch to my ranged weapon to shoot out of the sky. Oop. Well, let's go. I'm gonna run out of stamina regeneration potion at this rate, you asshole. Come back here. No. You gonna come after me? There we go. There we go. It's highly successful. Alright. Force push. Did that do anything? Oh, it staggered him. Cool. Ow. Looks like my roll worked, though. Hoo! He mad at me. Alright. Did he poison me? What's going on there? I am poisoned. Alright. Oh yeah, that knockback definitely helps. How you doing, buddy? Knock him out. Shoot him down. There we go. Oop. Nope, knockback didn't save me there. Alright, let's do, Quen. Oh, that's not what I was going for. Alright, let's try to shoot him down. Hey! Ooh! Come on, buddy. Just hit me real quick. Hit me. Hit me, baby, one more time. My loneliness is killing me. And I must confess that I still believe. Holy shit, he's not hitting me. He's really weak compared to the actual boss versions of this enemy. Like, really weak. What if I just set it on fire? That sounds like fun. Ow. Dick. What are you doing? Stop doing whatever you're doing. I don't like it. I'm gonna set you on fire now. Hey, I got a lot of fire damage. No, he's gone. Come back here. I didn't hit him that. Did not hit him there. As he flies around like crazy in a circle. There we go. Fire in the oh, not in range. What are you doing? Hit. Shoot him down. Oh, nope, that's not necessary right now. There we go. You enjoy that? All that burning damage? Oh yeah, fire is way more effective. Admittedly, I also buffed the crap out of that spell. And he's dead. Nope, not right. Ow, dick. Now he's dead. Alright, I think this guy might have been weak against fire, because that fire was really effective. Let's check the bestiary. Draconids? It is a draconid. No, it says it's weak against ard, huh? Yep. Draconid oil, grape shot, golden aureole? Aureole? In memory of the noble knight Roderick, slain during a valiant struggle against a basilisk, let's hope the beast choked on his bones. Gravestone inscription, Vizima Cemetery. Contrary to popular belief, basilisks cannot turn anything to stone with their gaze. That is small comfort, however, given their acid, venom, claws, and teeth provide them with many other ways to kill.
Yeah, he was dangerous.
No, not really. He was actually really...
Gather materials.
Let's see. Blue mutagen monster heart, basilisk mutagen, basilisk venom, basilisk hide. These are probably all handy, but let's find out what the actual treasure was, too, that he was guarding. Right over here. Coal, dark steel plate, cotton, dark oil, adendieth, really? An enhanced saddle. Ooh, enhanced saddle. Did I just pick up the same sword that I'm already using? I think I did. Yeah, that's adendieth. Same weapon, same weight. Looks like the one I picked up has... Huh. It says minus 13. They both say minus 13. Oh, it's because they're both damaged. So the one I just picked up has higher crit damage bonus, higher hard art and oxy sign intensity. So while the one I... Yep, I'm immediately getting screwed for putting that rune into this one because I immediately picked up a version of the sword that does more damage. Let's see. Item durability. Oh, this is an armor tool. Do I have a weapon durability one? That's 40%. That's not really worth using then. I'll have to repair to store. Let's see. Enhanced saddle. 25 stamina. My current one gave me 20 stamina. Alright. So I got a slightly better weapon and a slightly better saddle. So my reward was incremental improvement. It's better than the many times in RPGs I've gone to hunt down something and find out that's not even better. But now it's time to investigate the Griffin School location, which we'll find just past this ridge. Alright.
Giddy up.
We sort of got like two little mini boss encounters in this episode already.
Piece of filth.
What the fuck is happening to my horse right now? You guys saw that. You know what happened. I was weirdly buried underground a little bit. Let's see, how do I click to my... Oh, I'm being attacked. Oh, harpies. Okay. I got this. Hey, guys. You guys having a good time? Didn't really want to play with you today. Are they not even going to chase me? They don't even seem particularly intent on attacking me. Is there something to loot over here? But I'm in combat, so I can't. That's rather annoying. Alright, I guess I'll leave now, because they're not even, like... They're not even kind of attacking me. Why am I locked into combat? Alright, back to my objective, I guess. I'm not going to actively pursue combat if they're not even going to come after me. I've got plenty of other things to fight that are actually related to my objectives. Alright, switch back to my objective. 86 feet away. Yeah, I don't think I need to call Roach right now. Yep, there's the dramatic look. There's also a hidden treasure nearby. New marker, Lornrook. Will someone let me in? Aha. Oh. Ooh! What is that? What is that? Gross. It's a wyvern. We haven't seen those yet. Oh god, he's gross looking. Oh, he real gross looking. Alright. Quickly, let's Quen to recover some hit points here, because I need them. And then we'll start the fight in earnest. He's freaky looking. He's like a creepy little chicken version of a dragon. I've never seen a wyvern look like that before, with like no tail. He does look like a fucked up little evil bird lizard. There we go. Oh, I actually lost more hit points than I gained there from that particular last one. He probably shoots fire, so he's probably not weak against that. What if I... Can I mind control him from the air? Oh, I don't have the stamina right now. Shoot him down. There we go. He almost fell off the freaking roof. Hey, buddy. Alright, that wasn't super damaging. I can do it again, though. And then not land attacks over and over again. Don't fall off the cliff. Holy crap. Let's not play that way. Alright. Telekinetic blast. Boom. Ow, I missed. Rude. Oh, I cut him down when he's trying to fly away. That wasn't very effective at all. Alright. Quen. Give me my hit points back, boy. Give me them hit points. I also use Swallow and Tawny Oil to heal hit points faster and recover stamina. With stamina recovery, I might be able to just cast this indefinitely, actually. Irden. That might help, maybe. Are you vulnerable to fire at all? Seems to work more or less. Turns out no one likes being on fire in this game. Surprise. Alright, that was easy. God, my fire spell's effective. Can I loot it, or is it stuck? Oh, no. Did I just miss out on looting this thing because it's inside of a wall? I think that just happened. I think the game just screwed me that way. Alright, is anyone inside there that can let me in? What? Is this, that's just a fast travel post, so I can't... that's a fast way of getting back here, but it's not my objective. Search the ruins of the fortress by the lighthouse. That's a lighthouse, I assume. Is there a ruined fortress nearby? What's down there, swimming around? Oh, drowners, right. The ruins... ooh, a place of power. Well, that's worth investigating. How do I get down there safely? It doesn't look like I do. Let's see. I can't get over there, can I? I feel like this ends poorly. Hey, I know how to check. We'll just save right now. In the middle of our Griffin save. All right. I've got this. Oh, really? He died from that? I guess it was further down than it looked. All right. Well, I tried. He does not grab that ledge. Alright, thankfully I had the forethought to save right here, so all I lost was a little bit of loading time. I want that place of power. Also, I want the Griffin gear. So how do I get down there safely? There's a sort of a ledge over here. Maybe I can make it down here. Cover enough ground to get close enough to without dying. Yeah, it seems to have worked.
Place of power. Should draw from it.
Yes, I should. Let's get in there. Alright. Gimme.
You gained an ability point.
If I remember correctly, we left off in a position where I can't really invest it in anything. Yeah. Every single slot I have available to me has an ability that's maxed out. But it's more abilities to points to save up for later. I have 3 now. So when I decide what I want to put something into, it'll be set. Quen inside intensity increase means that I'll be more geared for defensive capabilities. The question is whether anything's around here. I don't know of a way to deal with the fact that there's a, see, we hold with square. Hold square to dive. There we go. Let's take a look around the perimeter and look for a cave entrance of some kind, if there is one. Don't have much faith in there being one. I have to be careful, of course, because drowners will just straight up kill me in the water. Because I can't, as far as I can remember, I don't think we can fight in the water. I don't know if I've tried spellcasting. We might be able to do that, but we can't fight with a weapon. I'm seeing no cave entrances. Huh. Unless I'm forgetting a mechanic, I might have to come back later. There might be a part in the story that where you can gain access to this particular drawbridge. Am I inside a cave? Nope. Nothing new here. Oh, there's a ramp. Can I climb up here? You can't do that now. Why can't I do that now? Ah. That ramp looks like a way up to me. Maybe I go back over... Oh, don't... Where are you going? I didn't even slightly press that direction. I was trying to go over here. I really hope that future patches significantly improve the process of controlling Geralt, because he's not the most graceful character. Come on, I'm just trying to walk towards the thing to see if I can climb on it. No, go towards the ramp. Come on. Nope, can't climb on it with anything. Alright. Well, this is a bummer.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
Really, Geralt? I couldn't imagine where it could be. Oh, can I climb up this thing? Ooh. No! Jump! Hit. There we go. Alright. Anything over here? I thought I saw something, maybe. Nope. Let's see if I can keep going up over here. Oh, progress. Can I jump onto something? Can I grab anything from here? Not necessarily. There's a window way up there, but I don't think that Geralt has those Assassin's Creed climbing skills. So... this might not be intentional. This might be a place I'm not really supposed to climb on. Or not. This seems janky as hell, so I don't think this is how I'm supposed to play the game, but I might be able to grab something from here. and get up there. Or I might fall down and die somewhere. Grab! This is the dumbest thing I've done in a while, isn't it? No! Alright, yeah, I'll come back later. Alright, we're here once again at the Hanged Man's Tree where you first enter this zone after completing the tutorial. I seem to find my way over here a lot. I'm going to head right over here because there's a question mark on the map that I want to investigate just to find out what it is. There's a weird structure around here. Then we'll be heading north-ish to see if we can search the Lord's Castle. Hopefully it's not locked off the way that the lighthouse seems to be.
Faster.
So what am I going to find over here? Is it a village? If it was a village, it'd probably just be on the map as a village. So if it is, it's probably somehow an overtaken village, or a mercenary, or bad guy stronghold of some kind. Maybe it'll be like Pike Island, where it's like a
go.
Devil's Pit. Yeah, it's
take it easy.
Sounds about right. So there's something going on in the Devil's Pit, huh? Oh yeah. Down there is definitely where you'd expect to find some people, but there's no people down there. All right, we'll investigate the question mark. See what we're coming up on. Oh, there's a building over here. Oh, it's a bandit camp. All right. See how you like my kit. All right, nope, that doesn't work on the locked door. Well, I don't feel bad looting like crazy if this is a bandit camp then. Even though it's awkward to try to loot in this game. Oh man. All of your stuff is mine. Oh man. I love bandits. They bleed all over the place and I get their stuff. And they haven't even been bleeding yet. All right. Can I just climb over their wall? No. Okay, I can just open it? Oh, I can. Okay. Howdy, y'all. We having us a fight? Don't actually see any bandits yet. Just more stuff to take from bandits. I like that part. Lesser Glyph of Igni, my favorite. Alchemy paste, dwarven stuff. Dwarven spirits, awesome. Where's the bad guy? There's something on the map over here. Oh, there they are. Oh, he's coming after me, ain't he? Oh, he noticed me. They're deserters. Oh, look, piggies. Hey guys, how you doing? You gonna come play with me? You gonna play with me? Come play with me. Come play with me. Come play with me. You're on fire. I'm sorry, but you're on fire. It's really unfortunate for you for a number of reasons. Hey guys, now you're both on fire. Oh, I missed you. I'm sorry I missed you back there. I'll catch you next time. Like so. Alright. Any friends sneaking up behind me? I thought I saw them on the map. There we go. Nice job blocking. Oh, you're on fire and your arm is sailing through the air. That's not ideal for a number of reasons. Who's coming up after me? There he is. I was wondering why I was blocking instead of looting. Burn! Burn! Just burn. Just accept it. You're not getting out of this. There we go. Ooh! Oh shit! Surprise off, cameraman. And he's on fire. That's the biggest surprise of them all. And another limb goes flying. Alright, I think that's all the bandits. God, humans are just such a joke compared to monsters in this game. Alright. Where's loot? They didn't drop anything? What kind of bandits are they? They don't even have pillaging. What did they even accomplish? Let's see. Heavy mace? Oh, it was on his arm that went sailing off in the other direction. That's why his body didn't have any loot, because his hand still had it. That's pretty funny. Empty bottles and vials, water. It's gotta be something major to loot around here, because there's actually still a waypoint saying, there's a bandit camp here, check it out! Stop extinguishing stuff. I wish I could toggle off the candle interaction altogether in this game. Like, I don't... Fine, have candles everywhere, cool. Go ahead. But I'm sick of accidentally interacting with them when I'm trying to loot things, because they made it one button. That's awkward. Oh, there's still a bad guy. Maybe that's why the bandit camp is still on my map. Hey, buddy. You're on fire. I don't want to alarm you, but you should be very alarmed right now. Alright, bye. Nice meeting you, sir. Give me your shit. A small blackjack. I'll sell it. Is it a blackjack or a backjack? Whatever. I call it copper. I guess they call them crowns in this game. Actually, I don't necessarily remember what the currency is made of in this game. Loot. There we go. No, now this is just more. I have to worry about a ladder and a candle when I'm trying to loot one thing. Oh, god damn it. This loot system needs a desperate overhaul. I'm pretty sure it's the single most complained about thing in the game. I guess just general navigation issues with Geralt in general are things people have an issue with. Looting. There we go. Is this a little dungeon over here? Can I hop over the fence? Can I blow it away? Maybe I need to back up a little bit? There's clearly something over there. But I don't necessarily have the ability to access it. Huh. Maybe you can only do it from the other side. Can I hit X to open it? No? Alright. So is the bandit camp off the map? Meaning I've more or less accomplished it? No, it's still in the map. Okay. There must be something worthwhile around here to loot or otherwise find. That's how I got down here, I think. Oop. Come on, there's probably a treasure chest around here or something. So I'm pretty sure I've made other bandit camps disappear at some point. Probably from looting. Oh yeah, there's a chest right there. That's the central loot of this camp. Silver ingot, leather straps, mountain folk boots, Griffin decoction, superior saddle, emerald dust. Did I just double increase my saddle's quality in one episode? Is superior better? Where's my saddle? That's the 21. Where's this other one? There it is. Yep, 30. Wow, I went from 20 to 25 to 30 in one episode. Go figure. A little bit other there's some other things around here, but yeah, that was definitely the thing that the symbol for the location was for, was just the chest. And I don't feel the need to continue to loot every little particle of the area. Oh! There's another one of you guys. I'm gonna kill your goat! Your goat's dead now. Your goat's dead. You might as well just give up now, because you're gonna starve without that goat. Silly. Here, I'll give you a chance to attack me. Come on. Whoopsie. I just wanted a chance to parry, frankly. Thank you for indulging me. I thanked you with death. There's more stuff over here. Ah! There's too much crap to pick up. Let's just do a quick scan for another chest, if there is one. Not really? Alright, there's all the ladders and stuff, too, to investigate. This place just goes on forever. Oh! Somehow fell off that. Oh, is there a chest up here? No, just more stuff. That's kind of... Oh, God! That's it. Garbage-ish. Alright, I'll grab the last thing real quick. Then we'll head out towards the Lord's Castle to see if I can do anything there before I move on to anything else. More lager and spirits and lighting candles in accident, goddammit. That's the most puzzling thing to me about the weird candle lighting issue is that, like, it happens so much that, like, it had to have come up in playtesting. I don't understand how that wasn't an issue that got fixed at some point. There's no way they don't know that there's like an annoying tendency to just get stuck lighting candles and climbing ladders when you're trying to do other things. Oh yeah, I can loot the goat that I killed. Or I can extinguish this fire over here on accident. Alright, that is a bandit, rowdy bandit cap taken care of. Still can't open this door. It'll take me an eternity to search that entire place for a key, assuming there's even one in the area. So we'll check back on the map and see what I can find here. There's the hangman's tree. There's a monster den. I think we found monster dens don't really get wiped out. Or maybe I can wipe that one out. Anyway, I'm gonna head towards this monster nest way up here on the way to the location where we can find the gear. Alright, we're closing in on the den now. Took a little bit of a run. Terrain's a little rocky around here. Let's see. I'll go ahead and just pop my potions on this one, too. They're neckers. I'll get ready with a fire spell. Pop a few things. Can I get down here without hurting myself, I hope? Nope, not really. Shit. Alright, well. We're gonna use my shield, then. To try to absorb some hit points back. Hey, guys. They're probably bad at getting through my shield. Yeah. Yeah. Alright. There's some free healing going on there.
Ooh,
I can use that. Hello, explodey thing.
Boom!
Oh, it's still alive? I don't like that. Let's fix that. Hey, buddy. All right, that's most of them taken care of. There's a corpse right here. Hey, Necker. Just want to go ahead and stop living. That'd be really handy. There we go.
Triple threat.
I don't know what that was for. Oh, I think it's for killing X number of people without getting hit at all. Which I don't think, I guess I've never done that before. I did say that trophy listed.
Necker's surface here. Dig their way out.
Well, they're not going to be doing that anymore. Well, right here. Oh, get away from it. There we go. What's right here? Can I touch it? Why can't... What am I doing right now? I'm getting hurt? What the... Oh! That's not an item. That's a beehive. Okay. Necker blood, Necker claw, Necker eye heart, skull, shard, egg. Alright. Straightforward enough. And then we're now in the vicinity. Alright, yeah, I was trying to interact with those things and... They look like loot to me, but nope, those were definitely... Oh, let's meditate real quick. Those were definitely just beehives. There we go, I should be refilled on my materials now. And quickly approaching this lord's castle, which I hopefully have access to, unlike the lighthouse. Alright, that looks like an opening. Oh, is that a chest over there? That sure looks like a chest. Do I get here? Ooh, journeyman repair kit. I'll take it. Let's wait up on this platform that I assume gets me access. Yep, there's a bridge. Multiple enemies straight ahead to watch out for. Is that a werewolf? That's something big and nasty. What do I have equipped right now? Wrong slot. No, it's the first slot, isn't it? Oh, usable items. It is in the slot. Just all the new items were distracting me. Necrophages, specters, cursed ones, non-humans. We're probably going to be fighting necrophages. We're in a swamp that usually has necrophages in it. If not, it's a good chance it's one of the things that I don't have the materials for anyway. We'll set up with the fire spell is really strong. New marker, hind hold. What is that? What is that? Oh no. Like giant beetle monster things? Wow, they're colorful. Ew. Dude, they're nasty. What are you guys? I don't like... Oh, it's a scorpion monster. I don't want it. I don't want it at all. Let's try to kill its extra adds if I can. There we go. I killed a worker. That'll give me something to start with, at least, for finding out what these things are. Oh, insectoid. New category. Andrega workers. I thought the workers were harmless. I thought wrong. Jane the Gimp Trapper. It's called the Gimp because of that, probably. Workers are the most numerous and thus the most frequently encountered caste of Andrega. Within the colony, their duty lies in the building nests and cocoons, acquiring food and caring for eggs and larvae. When threatened, they will summon warriors to aid them. Yet, if forced to defend themselves, they will and do surprisingly well. Weak against insectoid oil in golden aureola. Can I make insectoid oil is the question. I can't make it right now, obviously, because we're already in... Oh, I can make a blue mutagen. Might as well. Do I have the recipe for insectoid oil? I don't. Okay. Hey, buddy, you're pretty on fire over there. You gonna be okay? Whoops. All right. Let's do more reading here. Andrega warriors. Scared of those Andragas, are ya? Just wait till you see the warriors. Klaus Altman, Forrester. Endless waves of Andrega workers are enough to overcome most attackers, but when confronting more dangerous foes, Andrega colonies unleash their larger, stronger members, the so-called warriors. This caste lives only to fight, and gets ample opportunity to do so while defending the colony borders for our conquering new territory. Alright. Well, they seem very susceptible to fire, so... I'm just gonna keep cooking them. Seems to be the right approach. Looks like they're giving off a gas that'll probably hurt me. Oh wait, are their bodies explosive? Nope. Alright, well, I tried. A lot of gases explode in this game. Is that a fast travel location right here? Yep, sure is. All right, we'll take a look inside the fortress. Hello, warrior. Burn. Yes, you've got a burn. More burning. It's highly effective. Oh, shit, he's alive. I thought he was dead already. All right. There's a good chance that we're going to find something in here. Ooh, a chest. Florins. Dimitrium oil, coal, and crowns. These are all good things to find. Oh, yeah. My inventory is getting so much crap in this episode. Florins, twine, dark ingots, and crowns. A door I probably can't open, right? Although I can easily just go around it because there's a hole in the wall. Well, I mean, I already did. More loot. Ooh, hardened leather. That's good for crafting. It's relatively... If you buy it at a store, it's super expensive. But you can get it from dismantling equipment fairly easily. It's weird that it seems to be worth more than the equipment that it's contained in oftentimes. Not seeing anything to interact with around here. Dead horse. Gross. A little bit of mushroom matter. Alright. Ew, these are all webs. Is it highly flammable, like real webs? Answer appears to be no. But it also doesn't seem to grab me at all. Alright. We'll keep heading up. Fighting creepy monsters and shit. At least I seem to be able to walk into this place, unlike the last place we checked. Ooh, there's a monster nest here. Probably upstairs. Probably right up here. It's probably where all these creatures are coming. Oh, there's harpies. I didn't expect that. I thought we were going to keep fighting those monsters. Aha! I shot you out of the sky. Oh god, they're everywhere. Don't like it. No likey. No likey. No likey. Burn. There we go. That helped with the crowds. Ow, dick. Burn. There we go. That more or less took care of them. I really should have used Quen to restore some hit points, though, before I killed the last one. At least I wiped them out. Is someone attacking me? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Stop rolling. Okay, there's a harpy. Cool. He'll attack me, so I'll just put my shield up. Come on, harpy. Come get me. Yeah, you do that. Yeah, show me how tough you are and stuff. Aren't you great? Wow, he's not very aggressive right now. Come get me. I'm standing perfectly still. Need them hit points back. It's really unfortunate that this is like my most efficient way of restoring hit points right now, of all things. Like, the only thing stopping me really is impatience. Alright? Like this. Did I shoot him out of the sky? Ow, unsuccessful. Oh, I've missed that too. There we go. It happened. And now you're on fire. Wow, this one's surprisingly a little resilient. There we go. Now can I loot safely? Ew, they're gross looking. They are gross little bird people. Alright, so they have a nest around here. Oh, there it is. This much more literally a nest,
he's got their nest
as we think of it. There's something over there in the debris to check out. Let's get out of the explosion first. Fire in the hole! It's monster nest progress. Harpy eggs, feathers, harpy talons, iridin glyph, skull shard, powdered monster tissue. What's over here? I see you. Oil and crowns. Alright. We took out a monster nest, but we haven't found the griffin gear that's supposed to be here. Ooh, hello. Let's take a look at that. Fuck you, door. Was I too far away? There we go. I guess I didn't have to use a magic on that one at all. Oh, Witcher George's Confession and a Velen Axe. Is that what I was looking for? Or maybe that body over there has what I'm looking for, but let's look at the confession real quick. Over in usable quest items, right? What's that? I don't know. Book is burned, only a few pages still intact. I must have found this earlier. Evis Smilinit? Okay, that's all gibberish. That's another language I can't read. Alright, Witcher George's Confession. I, the undersigned George of Kagan, a witcher by trade, testify the following. While traveling through Velen, I received a summons to provide professional testimony in the matter of the accused Bartoslav of Lufield. This Bartoslav stands accused of causing several shipwrecks near the lighthouse, which it is his duty to keep. Ships led astray by errant signals of this lighthouse have repeatedly smashed against rocks near the shore, and the lighthouse keeper is held to be responsible for this state of affairs. During the trial, Bartoslav testified that he was diligent in the fulfillment of his duties and that accidents were caused by night wraiths deceiving sailors with their false glow. Having investigated the area, I can testify that I found no trace of night wraith activity. There are likewise no signs of noon wraiths, mamoons, air nymphs, or any other specters in the habit of misleading weary travelers journeying by foot, sea, or horse. I did, however, find the catastrophe's true cause. They were not the fault of the night wraiths blamed by the accused, but neither were they the fault of the lighthouse keeper themselves. The accidents were caused by local hooligans who have taken to lighting fires on the hill at night and then robbing the ships that subsequently wreck on the shore. I was put on their trial by Bartoslav's son, who showed me the ashes from their misleading fires. My testimony shows the lighthouse keeper Bartoslav of Lewfield is not guilty of the crime of which he is accused and should be set free. I also humbly ask for the bailiff to put the lighthouse keeper and his family under his protection. For in the light of revelations of Bartoslav's son, let me discover, there will be surely certain parties that will cause for vengeance. I cannot undertake this task of protecting the family myself, for I have accepted the contract to kill a dragon, said to be lurking atop Crookback Hills, and so must return here post-haste to kill the beast and complete my task. Signed, George of Kagan, Witcher, transcribed by Vincenzo Stock, Marshal of Royal Prefecture and the Gore's Villain. That's interesting. So earlier I had clues that led me to go to the lighthouse or here. I'm wondering if I was supposed to not be able to go in the lighthouse, and maybe this discovery is like, oh yeah, there's a dragon on top of a hill is actually where I'm going to find the Witcher gear. Maybe that's the important clue, and maybe the lighthouse was supposed to be a dead end, and that was just one of the two places this Witcher was supposed to be, because he was on a job. Let's see if we get an update. Or maybe it's just on his body right here. Ballistics, letter, and... oh, Griffin steel sword. Alright. Let's go ahead and look at this letter. Also going to be in quest items, I assume. May the gods smile on you and me, sis. Now I'm asking you to read this careful, for what I got to say is important. As soon as you set hands on this writing, gallop off to the fence, Kramer. Gallop off to that fence, Kramer, what's based in Maribor. Tell him we've got some first-class gear and Witcher sword diagrams to sell. Aye, I can see it now, scratching your head, or more likely your arse, and asking, did I hear that right? You sure did. 'Twas my luck to come to care for a Witcher that got me one foot in the grave and the other hovering right above. I just sat there looking at the poor man suffering in agony and thought to myself, he don't need this kit and these papers where he's going. Well, for us, that's the fixins we need to get us starting in the world of business. If we sell them for the right price, that is. I hear you fretting, not so stop. I didn't take everything. In fact, nobody will even realize aught of his shite's missing. Sad, though, ain't it? The Witcher's a good man. First he helped the Baronet solve the riddle of the lighthouse, what was sending ships into the rocks. Then he killed the dragon, ate all the peasants. Problem is, dragon's no easy pickups, and our valiant hero's got quite licking taking it out. He is done for, that's for certain, so as soon as they bury him in the tomb of Crookback Hills, I'll head straight to your place. Come to think of it, I'm curious how they'll put him in that crypt at all, for word is the vampires made it his lair. P.S. I also lifted a few flasks off the Witcher, but since they're not like to survive the journey, I reckon I'll sample them myself, see how Witcher hooch goes down. Maybe we'll make a business out of that, too. Your brother-in-law, eh, Balstick. So he was, he was probably about to send that letter out, but then he tried Witcher flasks, and so now he is the skeleton we see before us, dead, because Witcher flasks are incredibly poisonous to non-Witchers. Whoops. Here. In memoriam. So now it's, back to searching the fortress, the lighthouse. Is that, maybe that letter's gonna give me information? Maybe I have access to it now or something? I don't know. We'll do a quick scan of the area. Oh, there's another room. Is it the same room? Sure is. Alright. I want to do a quick look around just to see if there's any other items. I guess there's probably not, because we're already on the top floor. Alright. I'll do one more look at the lighthouse to see if I have access to anything as a result of what I've found. But, chances are I'm probably... I don't know, I feel like I'm stuck. Like I can't get in there. Thankfully there's a fast travel spot right here. Is there anything noteworthy around here on the map? There's a little walkway. Oh, there's a bridge. A very broken looking bridge. I'll take a look at the map. Does it go anywhere over there? There's more question marks over there, but that's it's probably for a future time. Oh yeah, that's over on the other side of the I've never crossed that river yet. There's a whole area. There's multiple notice boards. That's a capital city that everyone wants me to go to. There's a quest over there. Tons of question marks. But that's for future stuff. I'm still trying to clear out what I already have ahead of me. Alright, let's warp back to the lighthouse and see if I can figure anything out. Is that a... Oh, there's a cave. Oh, and there's drowners. Shit. Go. Crossbow. Oh. You can use a crossbow to defend yourself underwater. I didn't know that. Fuck you, drowner. Wow, that's really effective for some reason. Boom. Wow, okay. So yeah, I'm right by the... I just went right next to the place of power, and there's actually a way in. Alright, we're gonna get closure here. Anyone gonna come out after me? I don't recommend it. What's in this chest? Oil, cured leather, assassin's trousers, enhanced swallow, tier torchere blade, gnomish wow. How many things did I just get? Alright, first of all, let's look at enhanced blue mutagen. Greater blue mutagen. Green mutagen. As far as I can tell, there's no reason not to combine the mutagens. Like, the species-specific mutagens don't seem to count as those types. So I don't see a lot of reason not to make the various mutagen types. Because it means you can get more powerful things equipped on you. But, let's look at, there we go. Enhanced swallow. Vitality regenerates. Pause for 2 seconds upon receiving damage. Something's improved about this thing, right? Let's see. I don't have swallow in here. Right, I never had to craft swallow. No, I did have to craft swallow. Oh, well. It says it's better, so I'm just going to assume that it's actually better. Hopefully. Bam! Enhanced swallow acquired. I'm happy about that idea. Let's look at my items now. There we go. Did I just get 2 upgraded weapons? Tin torchere blade does 3 less damage than my current blade does. Let's see. 3 less damage, but has a 50% critical bonus and a 5 bonus crit. Oh, my current one has that too. Oh, 1 in 3 chance to cause bleeding, but otherwise it is lower level and lower damage. All right. Velen axe. That's, I found that earlier. Gnomish gear. That's the same weapon I'm using right now, but lower level. Should also sell for a decent amount. Was there something else I found? No, it was those 2 swords. Now, yeah, I remember. A whole lot of resources that I can just sort of highlight to make them stop being new. Anything over here? Just a lot of money. All right, let's try to get deeper into the keep to find what's left of the Griffin gear. Can I climb up here? Oh yeah, that looks like it'll take me where I want to go. Careful, don't fall, Geralt. We will die. Oh, that's ladder. Ladder. So is there any enemies in here or just cool loot? Go ahead and pull out that torch. No, not the ladder. Silly. Alright. These aren't lootable. These bags are. Bear hide. Looking for Griffin gear. Also a way to lower the drawbridge, hopefully. Oh, igniting things instead of looting. Disclare. Veerheld Brigade Sword. Another crap. Got 2 more goddamn swords. I think I'm gonna make a lot of money off of these. They're both noticeably weaker. It's also an axe. Alright, that'll all be worth something. Let's see. Keep heading up. More stuff. Hunting boots. Not super concerned about that because I have my Griffin set. Wow. More swords. Glowing ore. Enhanced cursed oil. Cool. I got a higher level version of cursed oil. Let's see if I can make that or not. Alcohol. Bombs. Decoctions. Oils. Enhanced cursed oil. I have the materials for it. 25% bonus damage against cursed ones. Seems worthwhile to me. There's definitely cursed ones to be found around. I assume everything else is just more duplicate weak weapons, because this seems to be a low-level quest. Actually, it's not a low-level quest. It's my level. Just all the loot is low-level. Good thing I increased my inventory space, because the stuff's getting heavy. Any bad guys around? There's another torch for me to light if I want to. Bam. There's the drawbridge. And light you too. There we go. Let's go ahead and drop this. There we go. Now I've got an easy way in from the fast travel location. Anything over here? No? Alright. Gotta be loot up here, probably. Oh! I just feel like I need to ignite all of these. It's like, this place is mine. I'm gonna light it up like a blight town. So it reflects my progress. Flawless Luby and amethyst dust. Hunting trousers. Water. Can I loot the bottom one? Looks like I can't. Alright, gonna keep going up. Maybe there's something up here. It's gotta be Witcher gear in here somewhere. That's like the whole point, right? There's also supposed to be some sort of hidden treasure around here that isn't the Witcher gear. Because that's listed separately. Hunting trousers. Ooh, a manuscript page. Someone's journal. Nilfgaardian guardsman's armor. And I'm overburdened. Ah, crap. Well, we'll look at the note. That's some decent armor. I have better at this point, but it's decent. Let's see. Let's get rid of some of these things I don't need to deal with. Yeah, these are like 6 pounds each, and they're not worth as much. This one's worth 37. Okay, screw that. 34. Drop. 34. Drop. 43. 462. Get rid of the 43. I'm not gonna. I'll get rid of everything that's white quality for now. Can I move now? I can move now. Cool. All right. What's in here? Oh, wait, I already looted that, didn't I? Alright, what's the note say? Over here in quest items, I assume? Yep. Dobromir's journal. Daz chewed my head off about going to the lighthouse, about the fire needin' tendin'. Thing is, don't give a plowin' rat's ass, frankly. What am I, some golem fit for not but climbing up there 4 times a day to drop off wood and pour oil? I'd much rather learn how to work a forge in town, or at least some gnomish foundry. Grandpa Amsbury was a smith, weren't he? Even forged Witcher blades. So who's to say none of his talent trickled down to me? Because that's not really how talent works, but, I mean, sure. Enjoy thinking that way. I'm just going to assume he's dead like everyone else in here. Oh, is that him? Trapper's boots. Repair kit. That's probably him dead. Oh, yeah, The guy said that the guy specifically said that everyone should be put under guard so they don't get killed, and I'm betting that oh crap, I'm betting that after people got caught for what they were doing, I'm betting these characters weren't put under guard and they all died, unfortunately. That's a loot bag. That's just all the stuff I dropped. I have not found the Witcher, the Griffin gear, and I want it. It's part of my ongoing set. Gotta get this shit complete. What do we have around here? Still empty, right? Is there a way further down? No. I've gotta be missing something then. Oh, there's a ladder up here. This has to be it, because there's nowhere else to go. Please get on the ladder. Please get on the ladder. Please get on the ladder. Do I have to, like, leave and come back? Please get on the ladder. There we go. Oh, that's what enhanced swallow is. I have 4 now instead of 3. I just noticed that. It's kind of a big deal. That'll improve. That's a grindstone, crafting notes, and Griffin silver sword. Now I have Griffin equipment for both sword slots, as I suspected early on. Hunting boots. All right, so quest complete, guys. Amethyst. Another curious. Is that all that's around here? It looks like it is. All right. Let's see what I found. I'm over-encumbered again. That's fine. I'll hobble back to town. Angrian curious. It's weak, but it's worth money. Similarly, oh, that one's worth some mad money. I might have to make my way into the capital or something and see if those people have more money, because I'm finding more and more things that seem like they're worth a lot, and I don't necessarily get the money worth when I try to use them. Crafting notes. Now there's a commission I haven't seen the likes in ages. Got a visit from that witcher the baronet summoned about them evil powers took over the lighthouse and were crashing ships against the rocks. He stood there in the doorway to my forge looking noble as a prince or duke or something, and said his silver sword got damaged during his last job. Blade was chipped bad, almost broken in two spots. I asked how he expected me to know how to fix a weapon like that, and he gave me a diagram and said I was to forge him a new one, and promised quite the sum in return. Damn near tuckered myself out making that thing. I did my apprenticeship with Master Barnaby of Novigrad, and I've made a Witcher blade or two in my life, but it's been over 3 years since I last touched anything of the sort. In the end, didn't matter, though. Before I could finish, the Witcher figured out what was going on at the lighthouse and had to make haste to the Baronet's castle, for the rest is ineligible. They were not happy to find out that they did a really tough job, and then the Witcher left town. Oh my god, look at all this loot that I have to highlight for it to not be listed as new anymore. Man, no wonder I'm over encumbered all the time. I'm finding all this crazy stuff. Well, on that topic then, let's see if I can, if I have the materials to craft these new Witcher blades. Let's narrow it down to swords. Silver sword, diagram, Griffin sword. We have everything. Awesome. And it does 7 more damage than my new silver sword does. It loses all of those other bonuses, but it gives me 5 sign intensity, and it gives me 20% bonus experience for monsters. In particular, I'm definitely into that sign intensity. Let's see. Only blacksmiths can. Okay. Griffin steel sword. It does more 8 more damage, 5 sign intensity, and 5% bonus experience from humans and non-humans. But I lose some crit bonuses. So basically, I'm basically becoming less and less effective in combat, specifically. But I'm getting more and more comical amounts of sign intensity to stack on top of all my stats. Can I go down this ladder without dying? Alright, cool. Let's navigate our way towards someone that can craft for me. Took a while to get here, but here I'm in Novigrad, where there's a few blacksmith-type characters around here I should be able to use. Beggar? That's not what I'm looking for. Oh, is it just the sharpening stone and that's it?
Watch where you step.
That's a bummer. Oh well. At least one of the NPCs around here can climb this? Cool. There's merchants around here that they'll probably buy stuff for me.
Don't think twice, just buy.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Hey! To me!
Talk to me, asshole.
Hey!
Why are you saying that? Why are you not gonna? You want to talk to me?
Don't think twice, just buy.
I'm trying to buy. You don't want me to buy from you? I guess.
Where's this side of the pond?
Oh, this guy has an icon. I guess he worked. I guess he.
Don't think twice, just buy.
Is it this one? That's obnoxious. There's a bunch
what
of.
Can I do you for?
It's like a bunch of fake merchants you can't talk to, I guess.
Let me see. Might pick something.
He's in the big city, so he's hopefully loaded. He is not loaded. He only has about 500 something. What's this? Paint? I need to complete a quest. What quest do I need paint for? Should I just grab that? I think I'm just going to grab that, I guess. It says it's needed for a quest. I'll find out later, I guess. Cordial. I don't care about his stuff. Let's just see if I can sell anything to him. Will he buy swords? Holy crap, he will, and he'll buy them for a large sum. Oh yeah, he more or less appreciates what some of the stuff is worth. Alright, let's get rid of some of these extra items I don't need. And just bleed him dry money-wise. Make some serious bank here. Okay. probably want to sell them to things that are worth less, just to clear inventories. No, the higher quality stuff, he'll get money, more money for. I kind of don't want to get rid of these relic swords. They seem like a big deal. Although, didn't get two of the same one? Oh well, let's clear out some of these heavy things that are keeping up my inventory. He's running out of money already. I'm going to have to find more merchants to completely drain of resources. He has 20 more. What's something that he'll buy for less than 20? These pants. Alright. Gotta find another shopkeeper. I just bled this guy dry.
So long.
At least he knows that my stuff's worth something and isn't trying to fleece me here. Alright, I had to come all the way down to Black Bow, which is just outside of the Crow's Perch area. Because this is the only blacksmith I've found so far. So if I'm lucky, he'll be able to craft the swords I learned how to make. And if I'm unlucky, well, we'll have to figure something else out. This downpour.
Yeah?
Got this diagram. Think you can forge the weapon?
Alright, let's get busy here. We're gonna go crafting. It's gonna be a silver sword. Craftsman's level's too low. Steel sword? Too low. Alright. I need to find a journeyman blacksmith to craft either of these swords, so we're gonna have to wait till a future episode where I find another blacksmith. Probably gonna be in that big capital. Probably. Let's see, I don't really want to repair all, because as much stuff in my inventory I don't want to repair, because I'm not even using it. Oh well. Can I buy anything from him? That's cool. He's got a bunch of runestones. He's got diagram for Gvenel and Disglare. And a bunch of weapons I don't necessarily have a reason to want. So I think my stuff's just probably going to be generally better. A few materials, and he's got fifth essence. I think I'll just pass on this guy altogether for now. Alright. Well, that's the dead end for us, guys. Thanks for watching, guys, like always. I'll see you next time. Hopefully in the near future we'll be able to actually build the swords I learned how to make this episode. But at least there's a whole other scavenger hunt off of my to-do list.